In this video, we're going to introduce function notation, which is a very common way of talking about inputs and outputs of a function in many math classes. Let's introduce a little terminology and get a feel for what function notation looks like. A typical statement in function notation will look like the example laid out here. We would read this as f of a equals b. There are three components to function notation. The first part here, f, tells us the name of the function. So this is our function name. The second component to the notation is the statement inside the parentheses here, in this case, a. This represents the input of the function. Function input. And lastly, on the other side of the equal sign, we have b. B represents the output of the function. Here are two examples of function notation using numbers. In the first one, we would read this as g of 7 equals 9. And so what this is telling us is that we have a function named g. It takes the input 7 and produces the output 9. If we wanted to write this as an ordered pair, 7 is our input and 9 is our output. That would tell us the ordered pair is 7, 9. The second example we would read as h of 0 equals negative 5. So once again, we have a function named h. It takes the input of 0 and produces the output of negative 5. So if we wanted to write this statement as an ordered pair, the input of 0 gives us an output of negative 5. 0, negative 5. Now let's see some examples of how function notation works with variables. Here we have two examples. In the first one, we would read this as f of x equals 3x minus 2. Now let's think for a second what that means. If we give this function the input x, it produces the output 3x minus 2. This is a more general statement than what we saw with the numbers in the last slide. What this is telling us is that for the function f, no matter what number we choose to give it as an input, this formula will tell you what the output is going to be. So, if we give it an input, what's going to happen to that input? Well, the first thing that's going to happen is it's going to get multiplied by 3. That's the 3x part. And then what happens after that? Then we subtract 2. So the function f is characterized by multiplying the input by 3 and then subtracting 2. Now let's see if we can analyze the other function in the same way. We would read this as g of x equals x squared plus 1. So let's see if we can figure out what this function does. When you give this function the input x, what's the first thing that happens to x? Well, x gets squared. So the first operation would be to square, and then what happens? After that, the result has 1 added to it, plus 1. So we square, then add 1. Let's revisit one example from the last slide, f of x equals 3x minus 2. Suppose we would like to find two input-output pairs for this function. We need a value to use as the input for the function. Since we weren't given any specific direction, we can pick any number we like. So let's pick 4. In other words, we would like to know, what is f of 4? Well, the way to figure it out is to plug in 4 where the x is in the formula. 3 times 4 minus 2. That's 12 minus 2 is 10. So we would say f of 4 equals 10. If we want to find another input-output pair for this function, we simply need to pick another input to plug in. Let's choose 0. We would like to know what's f of 0. Well, the process is the same. We're going to plug in 0 where the x was in the formula. 3 times 0 is 0, minus 2 gives us negative 2. So we would say f of 0 is negative 2.